"Why, here's a hole, an exit, an outlet!" exclaimed the Ork from above.
"We know," said Trot. "We found it last night."
"Well, then, let's be off,"
continued the Ork, after sticking its head into the black hole and sniffing once or twice.
"The air seems fresh and sweet, and it can't lead us to any worse place than this."
The girl and the sailor man got up and climbed to the side of the Ork.
"We'd about decided to explore this hole before you came," explained Cap'n Bill. "But it's a dangerous place to navigate in the dark, so wait till I light a candle."
"What is a candle?"
inquired the Ork.
"You'll see in a minute," said Trot.
The old sailor drew one of the candles from his right side pocket and the tin matchbook from his left pocket. When he lighted the match, the Ork gave a startled jump and eyed the flame suspiciously, but Cap'n Bill proceeded to light the candle, and the action interested the Ork very much.
"Light,"
it said somewhat nervously,
"is valuable in a hole of this sort. The candle is not dangerous, I hope?"
"Sometimes it burns your fingers," answered Trot, "but that's about the worst it can do, except to blow out when you don't want it to." Cap'n Bill shielded the flame with his hand and crept into the hole. It wasn't any too big for a grown man, but after he had crawled a few feet it grew larger. Trot came close behind him, and then the Ork followed.
"Seems like a regular tunnel," muttered the sailor man, who was creeping along awkwardly because of his wooden leg. The rocks, too, hurt his knees.
For nearly half an hour the three moved slowly along the tunnel, which made many twists and turns, and sometimes slanted downward and sometimes upward. Finally Cap'n Bill stopped short with an exclamation of disappointment and held the flickering candle far ahead to light the scene.
"What's wrong?" demanded Trot, who could see nothing because the sailor's form completely filled the hole.
"Why, we've come to the end of our travels, I guess," he replied.